Last time we were able to see how to export data to CSV and also Excel. So in this one, we are going to go ahead and also add ability to export data to PDF. So for example, you see when I click there, we get a view here that has the basically the data we want to export, and also it has the header and also the footer. It has pagination when we have different pages. So you can see we have, this is one page. So that's why you see page one of one, but if there are many, you can already see the page you're on. And then we have more data like the image. All right, so you see right here, you can actually download this to your computer. So it's gonna be awesome. If this is the first video you're finding, I recommend you check those ones out too. But in this one, let's go ahead and build this. So before we start, if you enjoy this kind of content, please remember to subscribe to the channel and let's get started. So we'll be using a module called WYSIWYG. So you can see that it makes the whole work of doing all this great stuff really chill and amazing. So I'm gonna bring this one into my, I'm gonna install it. So I'm gonna come over here. The server is stopped, so I'm gonna install it. So I can install it using ppm. Since I'm using ppm, but if you're using pip, you can also go ahead and install it that way. Okay, so as it installs, I'm going to go ahead and add a button which a user can click and they export data to the PDF. So here I'm going to change this one to PDF. So this can be any link on your website. So this will be export PDF. I'm going to change this one to info just so it looks a bit different. Okay, so once we have this, we need to set up this view that will handle basically the generation of the PDF. So in the views.py down at the end, I'm going to set up a view. So this is going to go to export_PDF. All right, so this of course takes in request. So now I'm going to add a pass here, then we'll come back to implementing it. So in the, let me first create a URL for it. So here, I'm going to copy this URL, and then now this one is gonna go to, is going to be going to views. So this one is gonna render PDF, export PDF. So I'm gonna change the name to match the one we have in the template, and also here. Okay, so if you come over here, you can see that we, when a user clicks export, we got this view called export PDF. So the URLs, the unique name should be similar, and then it renders export PDF. So in the views right here, we need to first create a response object like we've been doing for these other functions. So I'm actually going to copy the same, these two for the response. So I'm going to bring them here, then we walk over them. So once we use the HTTP response module, so we import that one from Django HTTP. So we create a file, then we define a content type. But since this is gonna be a PDF, it's gonna be application.pdf. Then the next thing we do is describe some more information to the response. Basically we want the name of the file. So this one is when it's gonna be PDF, of course. Then it's an chart, it's an attachment. Then we want to prefix this with an expenses. So this is gonna be expenses, then the current date, then .pdf. Just so it's unique, and whenever a user downloads it multiple times, it should be unique. Okay, so which is good. So the next thing you're going to need to do is set up the HTML that we'll see in the PDF. So the way we do that, so right here, I'm gonna create, this is in the templates for expenses. So I'm gonna create a file called PDF output .html. Okay, so right here, I'm going to actually bring in construct a basic HTML document. So I'm going to give it a title. All right, so for now, I'm going to keep it simple. So in the body, I'm basically going to have like a logo, which would be like a company logo. So I'm going to bring in an image, and then you see it points to a remote source. All right, so once we have this, I basically need to define the configuration for each page. So the way we do that is you're gonna set up a style tag here. So in the style, then we can define how each page will be. So right here, we use this decorator, so we can do page. So in here, we define the size. So the size is gonna be A4. Then we are gonna give each page some margins, so we can do margin. So when it comes to a, a page on a PDF. We will not be using pixels, as pixels are relative to a device that the user will be viewing it on. So we're going to use the standard centimeters. So we can do 2.5 centimeter, 1.5 centimeter, 3.5 centimeter, and then 1.5 centimeter. So just like with normal CSS, you do that, but then we use the centimeters. As like I mentioned, the pixels want to be relative to the PDF page, but as the pixels are relative to the device. So to keep it consistent, we use centimeters. All right, so if we want to add like a header, what would be, if we want to add like the header right here, we can now use this decorator. So something like top center, and then we can add the content. So the content here can be maybe the name, company name. So I'm gonna add a company name, post, something like that. All right, so once we have that, now we can go ahead and see how to render this basic one for now. Okay, so going back to our view, we have set our file name, we have set our content type to be PDF. So the next thing you're going to need to do is set the content transfer encoding to the response. So I'm gonna now come over here and do response content transfer encoding. So this is gonna be set to binary. Okay, so once we have this, basically, I need to render our HTML page, the one we just created. So we're going to use a utility called render to string. So I'm going to go up here, and actually I'm going to bring in some few more imports. So basically, we'll use render to string to bring in our template, and also we bring in HTML from WYSIWYG, just so we can work with HTML, and then we bring in temp file, because we're going to need to store the file temporarily as we are rendering it in the browser. So this is going to be used later to sum up the amounts. So anyway, so coming back down, we can define an HTML string. So this one is going to be equal to render to string. So as you know, render to string basically takes in a template. So in this case, our template will be in expenses, and we called it PDF output. Okay, so the next thing it takes in basically will be the content it will be rendering. So we are going to now pass in like the context. So we'll pass in the expenses just so we could loop over them and show them in the templates too. But for now, we will keep it to that. So I'm gonna actually make an empty list, we'll update it. So next thing, we are going to send the total. So that will be like the summation of all the amount of expenses. So for now, I'm gonna set it to zero, but we'll come back and update this. So once we set up the HTML string, we need to construct a real HTML that the WYSIWYG will understand. So here, I'm gonna set up HTML. So this one is gonna be equal to the imported HTML app. So HTML basically takes in the string. So now we can do string equals the string we already have, which would be HTML string. So down here, now we can create a result. So result, now this one will be equal to html.write underscore PDF. We now need to see how to store the PDF in memory as we are rendering it. So for us to do that, we are going to use temp file. So we need to bring in temp file. So actually we're bringing it in already. We'll use a context manager. So we'll do with temp file, then we call name temporary file. And then after we don't need it, so delete equals true. And then we're gonna do as output. So down here, now we can do output dot write. So write the result. Basically, in that case, that would be our HTML. That would be our PDF. So then we want to do output dot flash. Then we want to do, we now want to open the PDF. So we open that using the open module. So we do output equals open. And we open, basically that would be the output. So the file name will be output dot name. And then we want to read it we want to open it for reading, so we pass R. But since this is a binary file, we have to pass RB. Okay, so once we have that, now we need to write it to our response and then return it. So here we can do response dot write. Okay, so here we pass output dot read. So basically all the code we are writing here will be responsible to make sure that we can preview that PDF file in memory before we can print it or when we are trying to view it. Okay, so once we do that, now we need to return the response. So here we can return response. Okay, looking good. Okay, so I'm gonna restart the server. So once we run it, you can see that it's up. So I'm gonna open it up. Now you can see we have an option to export to PDF. So once I click on it, oh, we have an issue. So the template, let's see how we called it. So here it should be .html. Okay, let's retry. Let's go back here, reload, click export. And now you can see that it downloads the file. So once I click on the file, you see that it brings up the header we defined. You can see that it renders the image link. So now we need to add some dynamic content here so that we can put our expenses and maybe also add pagination and add a footer. So one thing that I've noticed though is that when we click on export PDF, you can see that it downloads the file directory. So a lot of times we might want to first view it through the browser. So for us to enable that, we are going to come to content disposition and also add this config for that, this inline config. So add inline there. And now if we come back and reload and click export PDF, you'll see that it doesn't download it directly and it opens it up in the viewer for the browser. So this can of course be helpful if you want to utilize these browser controls, or if you don't have a reader on your computer, you can utilize that, or if you want to print it. So that's why we have added the inline. Okay, so once we have that, now we need to get our expenses and also pass them to the template. So I'm gonna go ahead up here and copy the query that we used earlier. So I'm actually gonna copy this one. So I'm gonna copy that and also bring it here. So that will get all the user's expenses. So now we can pass them here. Expenses. So we would want to have the total of all expenses just so we can show it in the PDF. The total of all the amounts of expenses spent. So for us to do that, up here you notice that we imported the sum from DB models. So what you're going to do to get the sum of all the amounts is that, let's see, where is it? So here we can do sum equals expenses. Now it should be expenses, not expenses. So this, now we can do expenses dot aggregate. Then we use the sum, then pass in the field we want to aggregate on. So pass amount, and that will basically sum up all the amounts. Okay, so once you have that, of course we need to pass it in. So pass sum there. So once we have that, we can go to our PDF output and see how to render this. All right, so now that we are passing the expenses, so right here, after the image, I'm gonna set up an H2. So maybe I'm gonna say something like expense list. So after that, we need to basically display the expenses. So I'm gonna use a table. I'm gonna do table. So down here, I'm gonna have a T head, of course, T head. So in the T head, now we can have some rows. So in here, we can have some THs. So the first one is gonna be for the item number. So I'm gonna add a no there. Then I'm gonna duplicate it. So the second one is gonna be the amount. Third one, category. Another one will be the description. Then another one will be the, what is it called? The date. Then let's get rid of this. So after the TR, after the actually the T head, So this should be T head actually. T head. Okay, so now we can have the T body. So in the T body we can have rows, but the rows are going to need to be dynamic. So I'm going to loop over them. So here I can do for expense in expenses. Then we need to end for. So in here, now we can display each row. So we can do tier. I'm gonna copy this. So these are gonna be TDs. So you can actually select here and make sure they end with a D. TD. Okay, so the number, basically I want them to be something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, depending on where the item will be. So for us to do that, since we are in a for loop, we can actually use this filter. So we can do for loop dot counter. So that's gonna give us a one based counter. So what item one will be number one, number two as such. So now we can have expense dot amount here, dot amount. This one will be category. Gonna copy this category. Gonna duplicate it for here. So this is gonna be date, it's gonna be description. That will do it for displaying the items. So now to show the total of amounts, so I'm gonna go outside the loop, but still in the T body, and also add another TR. So here we can add a TR. So this TR can do, we'll basically have two TDs. So we'll clear these ones up. So the first one is gonna be total. Then this one will be the total. So since we passed the total two, we can now use that one here. Not sure how we called it. Let me take a look. Yeah, it's called total. Good. So once we have this, now we need to actually go ahead and set up the pagination links. So still in our page config, we can now decorate something called bottom right. So bottom dash right. So here now we can add some content. So this one is gonna be page. Then we use counter. So in this context, you're going to be able to have access to these things. So you pass page and then off and then counter pages. So counter pages. Okay, so you get access to this when you're in a context of the WYSIWYG print. And of course, the page should be in here. Okay, so once we have this, now let's test it out and see what we have. So if we click export to PDF, you can see that it opens up the PDF viewer, and it has added the paginations. So also you notice that we have the table here, but it's actually messed up. So let's see how we can make it look good. So table. So this, instead of having div equals table, this should be table. Okay, so let's reload it. Now you can see that we have a table. So looking good. So this is actually not entirely correct. So we need to only get the value on the total. So here in our view, we can pass sum dot like that. So if we come back and reload, you can see that the total is now okay. So we get our numbers, we get our amounts. So we can decide to print it or do whatever we want to do with it. So you can go ahead and style all this stuff using CSS like you saw. So I'm going to leave the link to the WYSIWYG print documentation in the description, just so you guys can check it out and see how much you can achieve with it. So I hope this video was helpful. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.